will see a learner student has written the journal entry which are incorrect. Correct them and rewrite. So see, narration is correct, only the journal entry is wrong. Okay, so from narration you have to check and you have to pass on the journal entry. See, first I am doing for you, that is being 700 paid for life insurance premium. See, life means it is related to your personal matter, not related to business. So it is drawings account is debited. So here what will be in place of insurance premium account, which account is affected, that is drawing account debited. Two cash is correct. So same way the entries you have to see, the narrations are correct but only the journal entries are wrong. So this you will do by your own for practice. Same way in question number 15, what is there? So accountant has written following journal entry without narration. Entries are given, that is correct, only narration is missing. You have to write down the narration. So I hope question number 14 and question number 15 you can do by your own. If then too you have some query, you can ask. Now we will shift on to the questions which are based on GST. Clear? In lesson number 3, the explanation is given to you for GST. So here we will be doing the sums. So from the following transaction, write the journal entries in the books of Shri Dinesh of Dahod. See, this is, he is from Dahod. It means he is from Gujarat. So that is very important to decide that Gujarat is your own state. Clear? So now they have given the GST rates. That is, the following GST rates are applicable to business of Shri Dinesh by GST is not included for the following transaction. Add applicable amount of GST and write down the journal entries. So these entries are given, but GST has been not calculated on it. So now you have to calculate these transactions along with the GST. So see, in the first transaction, first prepare the format like this. Okay, so here what they have given, see, in the first transaction, goods of rupees 5000 purchased at 10% trade discount from Suresh Bhai of Surendranagar. See, Surendranagar is in Gujarat only. So which two GST, that is CGST and SGST. I'll revise. CGST means central GST and SGST means, that is state GST, that is state goods and services tax, central goods and services tax. Clear? So as this is Surendranagar, Surendranagar is in Gujarat only. So these two rates are applicable and purchased goods are there. So you will see these two rates, that is 6% and 6%. But before calculating, what they have mentioned, 50,000 purchased at 10% trade discount. So first you will be calculating, that is trade discount. So see, the amount is 50,000 and 50,000, and on that you have to calculate 10% trade discount. So 50,000 minus trade discount, you are always doing minus. So minus how much percent? 10%. So 10 and then percentage sign. So what is the amount for you? That is 45,000. So first we will record this amount, that is we have purchased. Purchase, now you have learned that purchase is always debited. So first we will write down, that is purchase account debited. Amount is how much they have written? 45,000. Clear? Now what you have to do, you have to calculate the GST. See, whenever you are purchasing something, there will be GST, it will become an expense for you. Okay, so here you are purchasing, so you are paying the GST. So in purchase you are bringing the goods. Clear? So here which type of GST will come? So input word will come. Why input? Because you are bringing the goods in your business. So there is which GST? So input, that is first central, so CGST account debited, then input, now state, so SGST account debited. And now what you will do, you will be doing the payment by how? So you are doing the payment by check. So what you will write down, that is to bank account. Entry is clear. First of all, in front of purchase, 50,000 was the goods, 10% was trade discount. So deduct the amount of trade discount, whatever is coming, you will write down in this column, that is 45,000 in front of purchase. Now input. Why input? Because when you are purchasing the goods are coming in your business. So there will be input CGST. Same way when you are selling the goods, so your goods are going outside your business. So there will be output CGST and output SGST. So input and output is clear. In purchase, there will be input and this tax will be on debit side because you are paying this. When the sales is there, so you are selling the goods to someone, so you are receiving this CGST from someone, so that is known as output. Clear? So now see, how much rate of interest will be there? So we have seen here that there is on goods there is 6%. So on this there is 6% and on this also there is 6%. So this is for information we have written. Clear? So now on 45,000 you have to calculate 6%. So 45,000 is on calculator. Now here you will put multiple sign. See, minus sign is only coming in trade discount. Then if you are calculating cash discount, CGST, whatever GST is you are calculating, you will put multiple sign. So here multiply by 6%. What amount you are getting? 2700. As for both the rate of interest is same. So here rate of tax is same. So here you will write down that is 2700 and 2700. Now add all these three: 45,000, 2700, and 45,000, 2700, and 2700. So the amount you'll be getting that is 50,400. So this amount you'll be paying after doing the purchase. Clear? So here you can write down being goods purchased at 10% from Suresh Bhai of Surendranagar with 6% CGST and 6% SGST. So this is your transaction. Clear? See, in this case, if you don't want to mention this, you can write down this also, that with inclusive GST. So it is included that both the GSTs are covered. So in place of this, if you want to write down this word, then also it is okay. That is inclusive GST, everything is done. Now we will shift on to the next transaction, that is for the date 4th. So here we will put that is 4th. What is the transaction? C, goods of rupees 40,000 purchased at 10% cash discount from Vishnu Bhai of Varanasi. See, two important things are here. First, 10% cash discount. See, they have not mentioned that this is cash transaction because the party's name is mentioned, that is Vishnu Bhai. So still this transaction is a credit transaction for you. So this cash discount is not to be taken for consideration. You will not take this cash discount into consideration. Second important thing, that is Varanasi. Now Varanasi is outside Gujarat. So which type of tax will be applicable to this? That is I, that is integrated. So see, integrated, that is IGST, is how much? 12%. So directly 12% will be given. As it is outside Gujarat, there will be no central, there will be no state, directly IGST will be there. That is, this tax will be going directly to the central government. Clear? So here the transaction, again there is purchase. So first of all, what you will do, purchase is there. So purchase account debited. This trade discount you are not supposed to, cash discount you are not supposed to see, because this is still a credit transaction. So what you will do, that is fourth, you will write down first purchase account debited. The amount for the purchase is how much? That is 40,000. What is there? So there is integrated GST. So I, first you will write down input and then IGST. Purchase is there, so input will come, this will come on debit side. Account debited to, that is the part, payment is not done. So here the party's name will come, that is to Vishnu Bhai account. So now according to 12%, clear? So we will calculate on 40,000. 40,000 multiply by, see, you have to do multiple sign, and then 12%. So what you are getting? You are getting 4800. So 4800 you will write down here, 4800, and the total addition of this both, so 44800. Clear? Again, what you'll write down, being goods purchased from Vishnu Bhai of UP, inclusive of GST. Clear? This will be your narration. So here the transaction gets over. Then see the next transaction, that is transaction number, that is 7. What they have mentioned, goods of 60,000 rupees sold at 10% trade discount to Himanshu Bhai of Himmatnagar. See, Himmatnagar is there. That is within the boundary of Gujarat. So, this two only will be applicable. That is CGST and SGST. But your sales is there. Sales is there. So, input will not come. There will be output. Clear? And this will go on credit side. So, first of all, what is there? Goods of 60,000 sold to Himanshu Bhai. Himanshu Bhai. Sales is there. So, sales we are always recording on credit side. So, now Himanshu Bhai will be on debit side. So, the transaction for the date 7th, it will be Himanshu Bhai account debited. Then, to sales account. See, input will not come. So, debit side it will not come CGST and SGST. So, here we will write down on credit side only. So, to first output, first we have to give to central. So, CGST account debit account and then to output. Now, there will be state. So, SGST will come account. Clear? So, the goods, that is the cost of goods is 60,000 and 10% trade discount is there first of all. So what you will do, that is 60,000 minus trade discount, always put minus sign. So 10%, what you are getting, you are getting 54,000. Now this amount where you will put, you will put in front of sales. See, after deducting the trade discount, the amount will come in front of purchase and in front of sales. Remember that. Clear? So here in front of sales, it is on credit side. So on credit side, we will put 54,000. Clear? Now, how much is there? CGST and SGST, that is 6%. So on 54,000, now you will put multiple signs. So multiply by 6%. That is coming to 3240. So see, as both the rates are same, so 3240. Now what will be the addition of all this? So 3240 is already there on screen. Clear? So here 54,000 plus 3240 plus 3240. So what you are getting? You are getting that as 60,480. So that you will put in front of Himanshu Bhai, 60,480. Narration will be being goods sold to Himanshu Bhai at 10% TD inclusive of GST. Here, this will be your narration. Then the transaction for date 11 will be there. What is the transaction? See, goods of 50,000 sold at 10% trade discount to Shashikant of Shimla. See, again, Shimla is outside Gujarat. So, integrated goods and service tax will come, that is IGST will come, that is 12%, which will be directly payable to central government. And payment received through check. Now, here the payment is received through check. So, first of all, this is a cash transaction. As the payment is received in cash, you are selling the goods. So, here the payment is received in check. So, what you'll write down? You'll write down bank account debited to sales account. So first of all, we'll write down this bank account debited to sales account, and here to output and IGST account. This will be the entry. Clear? So out, whenever sales is there, output will be there, and output is always on credit side and input is always on debit side. Remember like that. Clear? So here, what you will do, this right now you will not write down. What is the amount? So 50,000 of goods is there, 10% trade discount is there. So first we will calculate that 50,000 minus for trade discount 10%. What you are getting? You are getting 45,000. So here you will write down in front of sales. Okay, 45,000. After trade discount, write down the amount in front of sales and purchase, in whichever transaction it is. Now there is IGST. IGST is how much? 12%. So multiply this amount by 12%. What you are getting? 5400. So your 5400 you will write down. Now add both of this. So 5400 plus what you are getting, directly you have to do plus on calculator, that is 50,400. So your write down this amount in front of bag, 50,400. Now being goods sold टू शशिकांत ऑफ शिमला एंड पेमेंट रिसीव्ड थ्रू चेक इंक्लूसिव ऑफ जीएसटी. क्लियर? दिस विल बी योर नरेशन. Now see the next transaction, that is for the date 15. So again here the month year was 2019 April. So 2019 April and the date is 15. What they are telling you, 1/4 goods returned to Vishnu Bhai and proportionate GST is adjusted. Now see, this is what Vishnu already transaction has taken place. We will see here. Vishnu is in transaction number, that is for the date 4th. What you have given, purchase account debited, input IGST account debited to Vishnu Bhai account. Now whenever there is return, you have to do exactly opposite of this entry. Clear? I have taught you that in normal journal entries also. So here whatever, whenever return is there, whatever you have done, exactly do the opposite. So first we will do the opposite of this. Clear? Then we will see how to find out the amounts. So what is the opposite of here? Purchase is here, debit side, and input is on debit side. So this will go on credit side, but in place of purchase there will be purchase return, and Vishnu is on credit side, so Vishnu Bhai will come on debit side. So see, Vishnu Bhai account debited. So here this is credit, so here it is debited. Now purchase account is debit, so to purchase return account, and then input IGST is there. So here again you will write down to input IGST account. Now see what they have given in the question, how much goods are being returned, that is 1/4. So see, nothing you have to do, only you have to do the 1/4 of this amount. So see, 40,000 of goods are this. When you'll do 1/4 of this goods, what you'll get? You'll get, that is 10,000. So see, 40,000 divided by 4. 1/4 means divided by 4. So 10,000, that is in front of purchase is there. So here in front of purchase return, you will write down 10,000. Clear? Then what is there? IGST is there, 4800. So 1/4 of 4800. So 4800 divided by 4, 1200. So that is here you will write down in front of input. Now see, after that who is there? Vishnu Bhai is there. Vishnu Bhai amount is how much? So 44,800. So here we will do 44,800 and then divided by 4. So what you are getting, that is 11200. So that you will write down in front of Vishnu Bhai, 11200. So see again, 10,000 plus 1200, so 11,200. Here also you are getting 11,200. So this way you will do the transaction for return. So what you will write down here, narration being goods returned to Vishnu Bhai and proportionate. How much goods is returned? Being, if you want to mention, being 1/4 goods returned to Vishnu Bhai and proportionate GST is adjusted. This will be your narration. The transaction gets over here. Then the next transaction, that is for the date 18th. What they have told you, 1/3 goods returned by Himanshu Bhai and proportionate CGST is adjusted. See how much goods is returned by Himanshu Bhai? 1/3. So again go back to the entry of Himanshu Bhai. This is the entry. Clear? Himanshu Bhai account debited 604800, two sales account, two output CGST, two output SGST. Now exactly opposite of this will do. So these three items are credit. So these three items will be on debit side. So see, that is the transaction for date 18. Clear? Now what is there first? Sales is there. So in place of sales, what you will write down? See, your sales is there. So in place of sales, you will write down sales return account debited. Then you will write down output CGST account debited. Then you will write down output SGST account debited, and here Himanshu Bhai is debited, so it will come on credit side. So to Himanshu Bhai account. Clear? Now what you have to do, how much you are returning? So that is 1/3. So divide all the items by 1, that is 3. So first, so see, we'll type the amount, that is 60,480. 1/3 is there, so divided by 3. Sorry, the amount was wrongly written. That is 60,480. By mistake, 1 was pressed on calculator. So divided by 3. So what you are getting? 20,160. This amount is in front of Himanshu Bhai. So this amount which you are getting on calculator, you will write down in front of Himanshu Bhai. That is 20,160. Clear? Now 54,000 is there, that is sales. So that you will write down in front of sales return. So here 54,000. So 54,000 divided by 3, the amount is coming, that is 18,000. So here in front of sales return, we'll write down 18,000 on debit side. Then here it is 3240. So 3240 divided by 3. So 1080. So here also 1080 and here also 1080. Clear? When you'll do the total of this, that is 18,000 plus 1080, so you'll get this, that is 20,160. Now we'll write down the narration, that is being goods, that is 1/3 goods returned by Himanshu Bhai and proportionate GST is adjusted. This will be your narration. Then see, the transaction for the date 25th, a cupboard of 20,000 purchased from Sajanand Furniture Mart of Ahmedabad. See, this good is of Ahmedabad only. Clear? So cupboard is purchased, cupboard is your furniture. So when furniture you are purchasing, you have learned that you will never write down the name of the word purchase, but you will write down the name of that particular asset. So cupboard is your furniture. So your what, which account will be debited? So furniture account debited. So the date is 25th, furniture account debited. Then as you have purchased this, so input will come. So input, and it is in Ahmedabad only. So first CGST will come, account debited. Again input SGST will come, account debited. Two, see, you have not paid the amount. What they have written, the shop name is written, that is to that is from Sajanand Furniture Mart, and they have not mentioned that whether it is cash transaction or not. So right now, as we have seen, we are seeing the name of the shop, it will be treating it as that is a credit transaction. So here to Sajanand Furniture Mart account. So what is the amount of that cupboard? That is 20,000. So here you'll write down in front of furniture, that is 20,000. Now CGST and both the rates were 6%, they have given. Okay, so here 20,000 multiply by 6%. So what is coming? 6%, that is 1200. So here 1200, here also 1200. So when you'll add all this, you will get, that is 22,400. Yeah, this will be the amount. Then now narration, being cupboard purchased from Sajanand Furniture Mart inclusive of GST. So this is your transaction. Then see the next transaction, what is there? Shop rent paid. Now see, rent is not goods, you're not purchasing or you're selling. So this is your service. So what rate of tax they have given for the services? So see, here they have written that on services CGST is 2.5 and IGST is, they have not mentioned the place that where you are paying. So you will be considering, that is CGST and SGST, clear? Because the place is not mentioned, so we are assuming that the shop is in Dahod itself, because the party is from Dahod. That is, here they have given that you are giving the journal entry for Dinesh Bhai, who is in Dahod. So we are assuming that the shop is located in Dahod itself. So how you will pass the entry? See. Sorry. So here the date is 28. Shop rent is your expense. So shop rent account debited. Now your this is expense. When you are purchasing, that is also one kind of expense for you. You are paying the money. So here also, which type of CGST will come? Input CGST will come. So for expenses and for purchases, remember input. For sales and for income, remember that is output. So your input CGST account debited, then input SGST account debited to this you are paying in cash shop rent. So shop rent account. Now what was the amount of rent? 8,000. Now for CGST for services it was 2.5%. So 8,000 into 2.5%, that is how much? So your two debit side 200 and your two cash account, so that is 8,400. Clear? So being rent paid for shop inclusive of GST. Clear? This will be your narration. Now what you will do, at the end you will put the total with double line. So the total that will be 2,68,240. So this side also 2,68,240. When you will do the total of all the for all the transactions from the starting till end, so you will get this total. So here you will put the word total. We'll see the last sum of this particular chapter, that is question number 17. From the following transaction, write journal entries in the books of Kians Patel from Keshar, and Keshod is in Gujarat itself. The following GST rates are applicable to business transaction of Sri Kians. GST is not included in this transaction. So we are supposed to calculate the amount of GST and we are supposed to write down the journal entries with GST. Your CGST, that is Central Goods and Service Tax, on goods it is given 9% and on service it is given 2.5%. Then next SGST, that is State Goods and Service Tax, again on goods it is 9% and on service it is 2.5%. Integrated Goods and Service Tax, that is on goods it is 18% and on services it is 5%. IGST will be calculated on the goods which are dealt not in Gujarat, which we have dealt in outside the Gujarat area. So on that areas, on that states, we will be calculating IGST. Now first, the transaction for the first date, that is 2019 May. So here in this way, we'll prepare the format of journal entry. First, we'll write down the year 2019 May and then first. So see, what is the transaction first year given? Goods of 40,000 rupees purchased at 10% trade discount and 10% cash discount from Savan Patel of Surat. Clear? That is given to us. So now your goods are purchased and it is purchased at 10% trade discount and 10% cash discount. See, but here it is not mentioned that cash is paid. So right now we'll be treating it as credit transaction, and according to credit transaction, that party's name is given. So we will record the goods on this party's name, that is Savan Patel account. Clear? Now purchase account is always what? It is always debited. So here the entry will be our first entry, that is purchase account debited. We have learned that whenever purchase is there, then input is there. Input, again now this is Surat itself, so this is within Gujarat. So here CGST and SGST will be calculated. So here we will write down input, and input is always coming on debit side whenever there is purchase. So input CGST account debited, then input SGST account debited. Two, as it is a credit transaction, we'll write down the name of the party, that is Savan. So 2 Savan Patel account. Clear? This will be the journal entry. Now see, what is the amount of goods? The amount of goods is 40,000 rupees. Clear? Here they have mentioned 40,000 rupees and trade discount is 10%. So first of all, we'll calculate a trade discount. So 40,000 minus 10%. What we are getting? 36,000 we are getting. So first of all, we'll write down here 36,000 in purchase account. That is 36,000. Now see, the rate of CGST is 9%. So now on this we will calculate 9%. So that is multiplied by 9%. That is 3240. So here we will write down 3240. Again here also 3240. Now the addition of this. So what you will get? 36,000 plus 3240 plus 3240. So that is coming 42480. So here you will write down that is 42480 in front of Savan Patel account. So narration we will write down: being goods purchased at 10% trade discount. Here they have mentioned 10% cash discount, but as it is a credit transaction, this cash discount will not be applicable on it. Okay, because party's name is there and they have not mentioned that whether it is cash transaction or not. Cash word is not mentioned. So goods purchased at 10% trade discount inclusive of GST is there. Clear? Now this will be the journal entry. Clear? Now we will see the next transaction. Now see the next transaction, that is on 3rd May. So here we will write down 3, that is 3rd date. Now goods of 30,000 purchased at 10% trade discount from Ayush of, that is Amravati, that is in Maharashtra. The payment is made by check. Now see, Maharashtra is outside Gujarat, so this is other state. As this is other state, we will be calculating integrated goods service tax, that is IGST. So here what you will do, first of all, what is there? Goods are purchased at 10% trade discount. Clear? Now goods are purchased, so what you will write down? First of all, purchase account debited. So here we will write down that is purchase account debited. Now here, as it is in Maharashtra, Amravati. Clear? So what you will do, you will calculate IGST. Now your purchase is there, so input will come on debit side. So input IGST account debited to, the payment is made through check. So what you will write down, that is to bank account. This will be recorded. Clear? This will be the journal entry. Now purchase is there and there is trade 10% trade discount. So on 30,000 you will calculate 10% trade discount. So see, 30,000 minus 10%, what you are getting? You are getting 27,000. So this 27,000 you will write down in front of purchase. So here 27,000. As there is IGST, so the rate of IGST is 18%. So multiplied by 18%. So if what you get? You get that is 4,860. So that is your input IGST. Here you will record 4,860. Now plus and then is equals to plus you will do. So what you are getting? 31,860. So the addition of 27,000 plus 4,860, that is coming 31,860. Clear? So this will be recorded on in bank account. So here what you'll write down? Being goods purchased from Ayush of Amravati and payment is made by check inclusive of GST. This is your narration. Clear? Now we will see the next transaction, that is for the date 5th. What is the transaction? See, गुड्स ऑफ 50,000 सोल्ड एट 10% ट्रेड डिस्काउंट टू अंश अवस्थी ऑफ अहमदाबाद. अमाउंट इज रिसीव थ्रू चेक. सी नाउ दैट इज द पार्टी इज फ्रॉम अहमदाबाद इट सेल्फ दैट इज विद इन द बाउंड्री ऑफ गुजरात एंड देर इज ट्रेड डिस्काउंट ऑन 50,000 गुड्स आर सोल्ड. सो वॉट यू विल राइट डाउन योर एज गुड्स इज सोल्ड एंड द अमाउंट इज रिसीव्ड बाय चेक. सो यू विल राइट डाउन दैट इज विच हाउ मच अमाउंट. सी हाफ अमाउंट इज रिसीव्ड बाय चेक. Half amount is received by check. It means for half amount you have to write down the party's name and sales. Sales you are recording on which side? So sales you are recording on credit side. So debit side what will be there? So party's name will be there. That is Ansh account. First we will write down Ansh account debited. Then half amount is paid by check. So bank account debited to. What you will write down here? So to that is sales account. Now as sales is there, so output will be there. So to output. Now what is there? This transaction is taking place within the boundary of Gujarat, that is in Ahmedabad. So here first we'll write down to output CGST account and to output SGST account. Clear? So this will be the transaction, that is sales is taking place. So sales will come on credit side. Half amount is paid by check, half amount is not paid. So for half amount the party's name will come here, that is Ansh account debited, and out sales is there. So output will be coming on credit side, output CGST and output SGST, because the transaction is taking place in Ahmedabad. Now what you will do? So here what is they have given? That is 50,000 goods is there and 10% trade discount is there. So here calculate 50,000 and there here what you have to do. So 50,000 trade discount is there 10%, so minus and then 10%. What you are getting? You are getting that is 45,000. So 45,000, where you will write down this 45,000? So in front of sales you will write down this 45,000. Okay, then you will include this CGST and SGST amount, then the amount will be divided in half in both Ansh and bank. So first 45,000 we will write down here on credit side in front of sales. Now on this 45,000, what is the amount of CGST and SGST? That is 9%. So here multiple sign you will put and then 9%. So what is coming? That is 4050. So that you will record here in output CGST and SGST. So 4050. Now add both the amounts. So 4050 is already added. Now add one more, that is plus 4050. What amount you are getting? You are getting that is 53,100. We have added all these three, 45,000, 4,050, 4,050. So we are getting that is the amount 53,100. Now half amount is paid by check and half amount is not paid. So for half amount the party's name will come. So half of, so divided by 2. What you are getting? So 26,550. So this amount you will record one in Ansh, that is 26,550, and another 26,550 you will record in bank, because half amount is paid by check. So here what you will do? Being goods sold to Ansh at 10% TD, half amount is received through check inclusive of GST. This is our transaction. Clear? So here the entry gets over. Then next, which entry is coming? So for the date 8th, that is, now see the transaction for the date 8th. Goods of 20,000 sold at 10% trade discount and 5% cash discount to Neil Mehta of Nagpur, that is Maharashtra. See, now again Maharashtra, that is in Nagpur. Maharashtra is outside Gujarat. So again here integrated GST will be calculated, that is 18%, which will be payable directly to central government. Clear? So now your goods are sold. Sales is there, so sales will come on credit side. See here they have mentioned cash discount, but they have not mentioned that whether this transaction is that is the cash is paid or not, but party's name is mentioned. So this we will not consider, as it is a credit transaction. Nothing is mentioned, party's name is mentioned, so we will treat it as a credit transaction. Now sales is there, so sales will be credit and Neel Mehta's name will be debited. So here the transaction will be like this, that is Neel Mehta account debited to sales account, and then to output IGST account. Clear? Because this transaction is taking place in Maharashtra. Clear? So your IGST will be calculated. Now what is the amount of goods sold? That is 20,000 at 10% trade discount. Cash discount we are not supposed to calculate because cash word is not there and party's name is there. So we are treating this transaction as a credit transaction. Clear? So here when you'll calculate 20,000 and then minus 10%, so what it is coming here, it will be 18,000. So here in front of sales we will write down, that is 18,000. Now on this 18,000 you will calculate IGST, that is 18%. So multiply it by 18%. So what you are getting, you are getting, that is 3240. So here we will write down, that is 3240. See, by mistake I have written 18,000 credit side, 2 sales is there, so this amount will come here, that is 18,000. Now 18,000 plus this 3240, so press plus sign, what you are getting, that is 21240. So here 21240, so add both the amounts. If you don't have cashew calculator, then in another calculator press plus sign and then is equals to sign, so you will get this amount, that is 21240. So this will be a transaction. Clear? The narration will be, being goods sold to Ansh, not Ansh, sorry, Neel Mehta of Nagpur. Clear? Inclusive of CG, inclusive of IGST. Clear? Or only GST if you want to write down, then it also it is okay. Clear? So this is your 8th transaction. Now we will be moving to, that is transaction number 11. See what they have given, 1/4 goods returned to Savan Patel of Surat, the proportionate amount. See here, 1/4 goods returned to Savan Patel of Surat, the proportionate amount of GST is adjusted. Now we have to see that when it was for Savan. So see, Savan Patel transaction is the transaction which is related to the date first. How much they are returning? So they are returning, that is 1/4 of the goods inclusive of all taxes. So what I have taught you, exactly opposite entry will do. Savan Patel is here on credit side. So here in this particular transaction, which is for the date 11. So here date 11, Savan Patel, see here it is on credit side. So here it will be on debit side. Savan Patel account debited. Then here there is purchase account debited. So here there will be 2 purchase return account. Here input CGST and input SGST same will come. So 2 input CGST account, 2 input SGST account. Clear? Now how much goods they have told they are returning? So 1/4. 1/4 means same amount you will take, but you will divide it by 4. So see, in purchase what amount is there? 36,000. So here 36,000 divided by 4, what you are getting? 9,000. So this amount is here in purchase, so in purchase return you will put 9,000. So on credit side it is there, so 9,000 you will put here. Then 3240, so here 3240 divided by 4, so what you are getting? 810. So here input and input CGST and SGST will write down 810 and 810. Either you add this 3, or you can see that in Savan Patel what amount is there? 42480. So here 42480 divided by 4, 1/4 you have to do. So that is 10620. So here in Savan Patel it was 42480. So when you are dividing it by 4, you are getting 10620. So this is your transaction. Clear? You will write down the narration, being goods return, that is here it is to Savan Patel, to Savan Patel, that is with proportionate GST, that is GST added. Clear? So inclusive of all the GST proportionate, the transaction have been cleared. Then what they have mentioned, see in the next transaction, that is 1/5 goods received from Neel Mehta of Nagpur, the proportionate amount of GST has been adjusted. Clear? So 1/5. Now Nagpur of Neel Mehta. So we will see where we have passed the Neel Mehta transaction. See here it is Neel Mehta's transaction. So Neel Mehta account is debited. So here Neel Mehta account will be credited in this particular transaction. Then sales is credited. So here sales will be debited. Output IGST is there. Credit side. So your output IGST will be on debit side. So see what you will do. So that is the date for this transaction is 16. So here we will write down 16. First we will start with sales. Your credit side it is sales. So this will come on debit side. So here we will write down sales return account debited, then output IGST. So output IGST account debited, and then to Neel Mehta account. Clear? Now see Neel Mehta account 21240, and how much they have told, that is 1/5 of the goods are returned. So you will divide it by 5. So here in Neel Mehta, what is the amount? 21240. So here 21240 divided by 5. What we are getting? 4248. So in Neel Mehta, what amount you will put? So you will put 4248. So see here there is Neel Mehta, here on credit side 4248. Then here 18,000 sales is there. So 18,000 divided by 5. What you are getting? 3600. So 18,000 was in sales. So in sales return, what you will write down? That is 3600. Now in output IGST it is 3240. So 3240 divided by 5. What you will get? That is 648. So here 648. Now when you add this 3600 to 648, you will get the same amount. So we can write down here being goods return to Neel Mehta with proportionate GST inclusive. Clear? So this is done here. Then we will see the next entry. The next entry, see what they have given. They have given that a computer of 40,000 for office from Shubham in Shubh Infotech is taken. The payment is made by check. So see, now you are purchasing a computer, clear, for the office from Shubh Infotech. The payment is made by check. So here this is not a credit transaction, but it is a cash transaction. Computer is an asset. So whenever you are purchasing a an asset, we will write down that is the name of that asset on debit side. So see, for the date 24th, the transaction will be what? That is computer account debited. Now this we are thinking that this Infotech, nothing is mentioned, it means it is in Gujarat itself, that is in Keshor. Okay, you are purchasing from there. So here we will put as you are purchasing. So input CGST account debited, then again input SGST account debited to, the payment is made by check, they have mentioned here. So here to bank account. Clear? So here what is the amount of computer? The amount of computer is 40,000. So here we will write down that is 40,000. Now what CGST is there? So 9%. So on 40,000, what will be 9%? So 40,000 into 9%, that is 3600. So here you will write CGST and SGST, that is 3600. and 3600. The total of all these three, 40,000, 3600 and 3600, it is coming up to 47,200. Clear? Now we will write down the narration. Being computer purchased and payment made by check inclusive of all, that is inclusive of CGST. Clear? That will be your narration. Now see the transaction for the date 30. Office rent of 10,000 paid by check. See, office rent is one type of service. Clear? Now this office rent is paid. So office rent is right now an expense for you. So expense will be debited. So see the transaction for the date 30. That is office rent account debited. And whenever there are expenses, the CGST and SGST will be input. So your input CGST account debited, and then input SGST account debited. This all you are paying by check. So what it will be, that is to bank account. Clear? Now what is the amount of office rent? The amount of office rent is, that is 10,000. So here we will write down, that is 10,000. Now the rate of CGST and SGST on service, that is 2.5. So on 10,000 we will calculate, that is 2.5. So 10,000 multiply by 2.5%, that is 250. So year 250, year 250, and the total of all these three will be 10,500 in this credit side bank column. So narration will be, being paid office rent by check inclusive of GST. Clear? This is the narration. Then we'll see the next transaction. Now see the entry for the date 31st, that is godown rent of rupees 20,000 received by check. Now this is your income. See, you are receiving this. So godown rent is your income, and income you have learned that it is always credited, and you are receiving check, so bank account will be debited. So how the transaction will take place for 31C? That is bank account debited to godown rent account, as this is your income, then to. Now see, it is coming this side. On credit side, CGST and SGST, whenever it is coming, so on expenses it was input, so or on income it will be output. So here you will write down to output CGST account and to output, that is SGST account. Again, go down rent is what? It is your service. So for service, how much percent they have given? That is, they have mentioned 2.5%. So here what will be? That is rent you are receiving, that is of rupees 20,000. So here you will write down 20,000 on rent column, in rent column. Now it is 2.5%, so on 20,000 multiply by 2.5%, so it is coming how much? 500 it is coming. So here you will write down 500, here you will write down 500, and here you will write down 21,000. Clear? This will be the journal entry. Now the narration for this we will pass, it is like this. Being go down rent received by check inclusive of GST. Clear? This will be the narration. Okay, then we will see the transaction for the next date, that is again 31st only they have mentioned. Now see the last transaction, that is rupees 25,000 received for commission by check from trader of Bhopal, that is Madhya Pradesh. See, now they have mentioned Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh, which is outside the border of Gujarat. So here which integrated GST will be there, but this is commission. Commission, again, it is service, it is not goods. You are not selling or purchasing, it is commission you are receiving. This is first thing, this is your income, and plus it is not in Gujarat, so this will come, that is IGST, that is 5%. Second thing, as it is income, there will be output, not input. So here you are receiving a check. So how the entry will take place? So here check is there. So what it will be, bank account debited as you are receiving the check, and commission is your income. So commission will go on credit side. So see how we will write down the entry. So your bank account debited to commission, that is you have received, so it is income, so commission received account, and you have received outside Gujarat. So outside Gujarat, Bhopal is there, so IGST will come. So IGST for go down, because for commission it is there. Commission is one type of service. So here 5% we have taken. So here 2 income is there, so there will be output to output IGST account, that will be recorded. So your commission received was of rupees 25,000. So in front of commission, what you'll write down, you'll write down your 25,000. Now the rate of GST, we have seen that it is 5%. So on 25,000, we'll calculate 5% into 5%. What you are getting? 1250. So here we will write down in front of output IGST 1250. This 2 will you will add, so plus sign. So how much you are getting? 26250. So here in bank column you will write down 26250. This amount will be recorded. So here being commission received by check from Bhopal inclusive of GST, this will be your narration. At the end you will do the total of all the transaction, that is from transaction 1 from May 1 to 31st. So the total you will get, that is 268,498. So here also 268,498, and at the end what you will do, so you will put the double line below the total and single line above the total, and here you will write down the word total. So here your lesson number 4 journal is over. If you still have any query, please do ask.